Ego and love. Ego and love are poles asunder. They never meet. They can never coexist. One is the absence of the other. Ego is the absence of love. Ego never fulfills you. But man remains in an illusion that ego is giving the fulfillment. At the end of the day, you realize that all these things have been wasted. But man does everything to fulfill the ego. Instead, let your profession be your love. Whether you are speaking, whether you are engaged in the work of transformation of human consciousness, or any profession, for instance, cooking. I do cooking for my own pleasure. I speak to you for my own fulfillment. It has nothing to do if there is someone to listen to it or there is no one. I do my job, attain to fulfillment, and then leave it for people whether they appreciate it or not. I am convinced to live within that whatever I am doing, it is evolving out of my deepest recesses, out of my emptiness, out of my science. It must have transforming effects. And that I can see in people. Those who have been connected with me in one way or the other, I can see their transformation taking place. Something has changed. When you look at the people, their entire life, inner life, is in a disarray, the emotions. And emotions are disarrayed because of the upbringing in the early childhood. And then when you enter into male-female relationship, the lack of unfulfillment, because again the ego comes to play its part in that relationship. And that creates many kind of problems. And it is very difficult to sort out the problems that relate to male-female relation in an ordinary way. You have to use, the master has to devise a different roundabout way so that the people who are unfulfilled as far as the male-female relation is concerned, some way can be found that they attain to fulfillment. Cooking is one of the methods. All those people who are excelling in cooking and who have made cooking as their love, as their joy, as the expression of something from within, they will realize that there is a different kind of fulfillment that is coming to them, is sprouting in them, which cannot come even with the male-female relation, with sex as well. It is something of a different nature. But this cooking, your whatever you are doing, cooking, singing, music, has to be your love, not a stage performance. You will grow, you will learn, you will evolve to deeper recesses of your being, of your emptiness. It simply, ego seems to be fulfilling, it appears. And you are disillusioned that ego fulfills, but it never does any fulfillment to you. Instead, it creates many kinds of problems, and then ultimately you reach to a stage where you become completely disenchanted with life, living, and all kinds of relations. You develop a complete distrust as far as the relationships are concerned. But when you go into the art of, when you understand the art and the science of cooking, you pour your love, your being into it, you get a totally different kind of fulfillment that is inexpressible and you cannot explain it into the words. Ego goes on agreeing for wrong things, and because the ego can exist only with the wrong, it continues to be nourished It remains self-perpetuating. It feeds on the wrong. So whenever you feel that your ego is fulfilled, be aware. Ego is something that you have eaten, something that is wrong. You have swallowed something wrong. And whenever you feel egoless, relaxed, now you have eaten the right, something which is in tune with your nature, with your innerness, that will give you the satiation of a different quality, something that cannot be explained into the world. Ego arises out of disturbance, but ego has its own logic. That is why I emphasize, let your love for whatever profession is, whatever you like, whether it is gardening, whether it is cooking, whether it is music, whether it is song, whether it is a dance, let it evolve out of your emptiness. Then it will not have traces of ego in it. Remember, ego arises out of disturbance, but ego has its own logic. It goes on saying that you are important, that you are the most important person in the world, and then you have to prove it. And we are all trying to do this one way or the other. Somebody does it by possessing money, other a beautiful woman or a man, or prestige, power, becoming an artist, a poet, a Mahatma. All is nourishing ego. But we are all trying in some way or the other to prove our innermost fantasy that we are the most important person in the world. Then you cannot be a lover. Then whatever you do will not have the taste of the beyond. Your song, your dance, your dishes will not have the taste of the beyond, because ego feeds on ambition, and ambition is poison for love. A lover is not in any need to prove. In fact, he knows that he is loved, and that is enough. That is the fulfillment unto itself. Try to diagnose it very carefully. When you are not loved, and how can you be loved if you do not love? Then you are not loved, and also you do not have love. Suddenly a great need arises to perform, to do something, to show the world that you are important, that you are needed. There is a great need to be needed. You feel futile, impotent, and useless. If you are not needed, the need in itself is not wrong. It is a love. Indeed, it is a love need to be needed. If a woman loves you, you are fulfilled. Somebody needs you, you are significant. Then you do not worry about the crowd. You do not go into the marketplace and shout, I am important. Then you are not ambitious. You do not collect money like an obsession. If somebody loves you, in that love you are dignified. If somebody likes the dish that you create, you are dignified. You become the greatest sovereign. Love makes you an emperor. Love brings the ultimate fulfillment. And when you love something, when you love your profession, and when you are singing, are you singing for a stage performance? Are you cooking for a stage performance? Or for your own fulfillment? If it is for your own fulfillment, then it will fulfill you so deeply and so greatly that there is no need to perform or do anything. Ego simply does not exist with love. But if that need is unfulfilled, then you will try to fulfill it somehow. You would like to become a very famous man, so many people need you. But remember to be loved by one, and to be needed by millions is not same in any way. Even a single person's love, even a single glance of love is enough. And then you can collect. On the contrary, You can collect millions of people and they can all look towards you, but that will not be satisfying. Power cannot fulfill a love need. You can possess great kingdoms, but that will not fulfill your love needs. But if you possess one heart which throbs in tune with you, then you are fulfilled in myriad ways. Then you continue to grow, evolve in a totally different way.